How many of you guys have heard this mantra? It does not matter what your blood group is, A positive or O positive. In life, you must always be positive. How many of you guys have heard this mantra? Always be grateful. Shift your attention from your problems to your blessings and feel your negativity melt away. And how many of you heard quotes like, it's not about what happens to you outside. It's about how you deal with it inside that changes your life positively. Now, being grateful and positive during difficult and troubled times is indeed uplifting, empowering, and very important as well. But then it's also very important to ensure that that positivity is not toxic. Toxic positivity means it doesn't matter what happens to you. It doesn't matter what you're going through. It doesn't matter how you feel. You have to always be positive. You may be going through intense emotional pain because of a recent heartbreak, or because of a separation or divorce in your marriage, or because of some misunderstandings, or because you may have lost your job, or because someone close to you may have passed away, or sometimes just because of a general sense of depression, the reason for which even you may not know. But it doesn't matter. You have to always just be positive. See, I'm not against being grateful or being positive. I've made N videos on this topic, written about it in the book Life's Amazing Secrets, posted hundreds of Instagram stories on positivity and stuff like that. All I'm trying to say is that toxic positivity is not a feeling that springs naturally from the heart. It seems to be like a forced imposition, either by my own self or by somebody else. Positive lag nahi raha hai, pain mein hu, fir bhi jabardasti se kheench taan kar mind par pressure daal raha hu ki isme kuch to acha dekhna padega, isme kuch to positive dhoondna padega. That pressure, that padega, that have to see the silver lining is toxic. Toxic positivity denies my negative feelings. It denies that I'm in pain. It denies that I'm just a human being, not some superhero from a movie who's beyond any feelings or emotions, regardless of what's happening to him. And such artificial positivity can be extremely harmful to our mental health, because it does not allow us to feel, to process, to go through our real emotions by trying to camouflage those emotions in layers of some intellectual reasoning or hope. For example, you may have lost your job and are going through anxiety, depression, and worry about your future. Toxic positivity means somebody telling you, or you telling yourself, be grateful that you're living. Be grateful that you have a roof above your head. Be grateful that you have food on your plate. Be grateful for your good health. And the endless list of optimism goes on and on and on. See, we can be extremely grateful for all what we have, but gratitude by itself does not do away with the pain that we may be going through right now because of having lost our job. Guys, real positivity allows us to acknowledge our pain and our negative feelings while we continue to look at our blessings. Real positivity gives us the confidence that it's all right to not be all right, at least in the moment right now. Real positivity allows us time for our feelings to settle and our hearts to heal. So the next time you're feeling low, beware of those pushy advisors who push the be positive mantra on you without being sensitive to your current emotional state. Rather, look for the empathetic supporters who lend you their ears to listen to your feelings without judging you and offer you their shoulder to put your head on and cry some tears. And if you haven't found someone like that yet, don't allow those feelings to pile up in your mind. Write them down. Practice journaling. Let the negative energy come out of your mind on paper. And if it's just beyond your capacity to handle, do make sure that you seek professional help. Also, remember to consume social media content with caution, with a pinch of salt. Because guys, nobody is posting their low moments. Nobody is posting their not so good pics, not so good looks. Nobody is posting real Insta stories. As much as negative content and news can make you feel negative, insensitive positive posts that put pressure on you to be positive can also make you negative. Because such posts make you feel inferior, make you feel guilty that you're not able to do it. Positivity is incredibly amazing. Just make sure that it's not toxic.